to wait.
This is very romantic.
Fuck off.
Behold, wars have started over uglier wenches. Well, raids have been undertaken at least.
True, she looks lovely. Let's go.
Whoa, whoa, hold!
Mean to go in, wearing that?
What else?
Have you seen how she's dressed? I'll not parade at that jewel's side in a rank tunic. You need a robe. One daren't attend a wedding in anything less.
Don't happen to have a robe handy.
What do you mean? What about that?
All in all, why not?
Ah, that's the spirit!
Ah, this'll do wonderfully. Perfect fit. It feels tailor-made. Now, for shoes. One must wear shoes to a wedding. And we must be neat. May they draw and quarter me if I've ever seen a lovelier lass.
Nothing left of you to draw and quarter, alas.
Doe eyes, a swan's soft, supple neck, and a waist so slim you could grip it one-handed.
You're actually quite amusing this way.
Be assured, you'll like me even better when you come to know me more intimately.
How intimately?
Enough to get a sense of my assets, my dear. Trust me, they're nothing to scoff at.
May I please speak to Geralt for a moment?
Whatever for. This evening is about my pleasure, not his.
Just for a moment. Then you can jump right back in.
Be quick! I'll not stand here doing naught. I'm to enjoy myself.
Geralt, I'm about to introduce you to the newlyweds. Please make sure your friend doesn't embarrass me.
I can't make him do anything. All that nonsense is his. I feel like an ass saying it.
I liked some of that nonsense.
We'll talk later. Let's go to this wedding. The sooner the ghost has his fun, the sooner this'll be over.
Finally, something that's not utter tripe. We shall dance till the break of dawn.
You get till midnight and not a second longer.
That's not enough. I shan't even get properly soused by midnight, let alone...
Make an effort. I'm sure you'll manage. You get to frolic and carouse till midnight. That's our deal. Then there's the capping. Then you go back where you came from.
So be it.
This way, my strawberry. Ah, hello world, I'm back. I'll be damned. A proper wedding. Overladen tables, plenty of worthy drinking companions, and a swarm of fair maids. But none compare to you, my dear Rhubarb. Beware of the dog, Shani. Judging by the size of its house, the mutt must be big as a horse.
Thanks for your concern, but the doghouse is empty.
They let a man-eater like that run free? Have the wedding guests been warned? Seems we are indeed in for a cracking good time.
Oh,
lovely rowan. I remember making necklaces of the fruit when I was a child.
Ah, the berries make for splendid hooch. Olgird and I brew it in our teething years.
I shall introduce you to the newlyweds now. Try to behave.
For you, my rowan petal, I'd do anything.
Time to say
hello. The long journey to be nice now.
Once more, all the best in your new life.
Thank you.
It's us now. Dearies, blessings rain down upon you.
May you live in health and happiness. Harmony and love forever last betwixt you.
Thank you, from the bottom of our hearts.
Now go. Enjoy the feast.
Our turn. My dear friend Aldona and her chosen one, Jonas.
It's an honor. The sun shine brightly on this new path in your lives. I am
This is my friend of yesteryear, Geralt of Rivia.
Yes, tis I, Geralt, a witcher. Heartfelt thanks for your hospitality. I adore weddings. The brides especially. So fragrant, so tasty, I could...
Righto. I'm sure we'll all have a splendid time.
We've chewed the fat enough. Time's a-wastin'.
Are you, expected elsewhere?
Me? Ha! I simply cannot wait to sample your liquors and dance with the local matrons.
Jonas and I invited more than a few lovely maidens. Perhaps one of them will catch your eye.
Oh, that's for damn certain.
And perhaps you will catch one of their...
It'd be nice, certainly, but I shan't be terribly bothered if it's not the case. Come, let's drink.
Seen what he pulled from the water? An old pot?
Mayhaps his lass wears pots for shoes, in case she can't find a privy.
You were supposed to fish out my slipper. Am I to dance now with one foot bared? Tis a wedding. I've got to wear slippers.
Oh, look, dearie. I did. Take there. Muck must have sucked it deep in.
Well, poke your paws in there. Rut for it. Rubbish game.
What's all this, then?
They're playing slip-in for a slipper. Never heard of it?
Never. Us gentry folk have other diversions. What's the object?
Maid tosses a shoe in the water. A man's got to dive in and fish it out. Oh, my.
Oh, there's more to come. Prime game. Shani, your slipper. I shall prove I dive to any depth for you. Observe, Shani.
My eyes are glued.
Thank you. sir.
Damn mucky that pond. Sank in up to my armpits.
I see no amount of silt could keep you from my shoe. And all the other shoes over tossed in the lake.
Always better to do a bit more and even gain naught by it than to do too little and face regret.
Oh, that's quite the theory.
One founded in practice. For instance, I can now approach the owner of any of these slippers, and she will lift up her skirt and bend over. To don it, of course.
Ah, so generous. And clever.
Just figuring that out? I believe I've earned a kiss.
Well, find the owners of those shoes. One might agree.
Don't be jealous, Shani. That was but a jest. I don't give a piffle about the others. Oh, well. Recognize this, Cinderella.
My shoe?
Now extend your supple leg and let me slide it in. That is, on.
Thank you.
Found yourself a perch from which to survey passing beaux?
What do you mean? My back aches from pounding the churn, so I'm having a...
And they said fire burns hotter in an old stove.
If I was your age, you'd be singing a different tune. Have you squealing like a kitty cat?
Look at the fool here going.
What sport is this? Blustering about after pigs, are you?
Lads are racing to be crowned King of the Swineherds and win the prize that comes with it for their wench. Lady, maybe.
And the rules? One must be a swineherd's son to enter, I suppose?
Nay, any man can try his luck. All you need is to herd the piggies dabbed in yellow into the pen.
Sounds like damned foolish nonsense. But why not give it a try?
We'd be honored. Get that cripple out of there! Could chase his own wench into a bed, let alone a pig into a pen. Let the Witcher give it a run.
Shame there's no painter here. It's a moment worth immortalizing for posterity.
Watch my movement, Shani. I'm spry as a cat and sly as a fox. I'll show these imbeciles how one chases a porker. Come on, piggy. Got a nice and cozy pen for you. You see that, Shani? One pig penned. Foolish peasants, learned a lesson from your better? Are the pigs penned? Indeed they are.
Whoa, Master Witcher. What were the trickery back there, the fancy finger twisting?
I know. Seen that afore. Witcher told a lad to go hang himself, drew some flowers in the air with his hand, and the man lost his mind.
Meaning you cheated and shan't be crowned King of the Swineherds.
Shani, what is it Geralt says in these situations? Damn it.
Yes, that's it.
Damn it. Now for what I say. Go shove rakes up your asses, you peasant curs. Do I look anything like a swineherd? Come, Shani, I've had enough of these hayseeds. Forgive me, Shani. I've let you down.
Are you worried about that pig? Oh, you needn't be.
We're here as a couple. I wanted to win you that thing.
Oh, really? It's unimportant. Nothing at all.
Tell me, Shani, what's the key with you?
What do you mean?
I'm on the prowl. That's clear. In Geralt's name and flesh, of course. But still... Yet the more I woo you, the less you seem ready to succumb. So I ask myself, what am I missing?
Perhaps perhaps you're just not my type. Considered that?
Rubbish. I'm every lass's type.
Is that so? Prove it.
With pleasure. Show me a lass, and I'll have her eating out of my hand in the blink of an eye.
That one, with the garland.
Splendid choice. Now observe as Vladimir von Evereck does his thing. Now, who have we here?
Do I know you?
That's the crux of it. We've not met. I've had to endure half a lifetime without you.
An entire lifetime, more like.
A moment, my dear. Do not sabotage me, Shani. That would not be fair.
Fine. I'll stay out of your way.
Did it hurt terribly, my sweet?
What?
When you fell from the heavens.
Why, sir?
Shh, my dear. No more words. I shall make a true lady of you. Arm in arm, we'll grace the finest salons.
Salons? Really? Actual salons? In Novigrad? And how...
In Novigrad? Oxenfurt? Why, in Kovir as well. Wherever you wish. Let's make haste to the barn. There, everything will be made clear.
Leski, step away from the man.
Who the devils are you?
We're the Mrs. Brothers, and we swore to our Da on his dying day we'd keep those of your ilk far from her.
Easy, lads. No harm done. An innocent conversation with an innocent miss. The kind weddings are for.
We all heard your innocent talk. Wanted to draw her to the barn. What were you going to do there? Talk some more?
Naturally, we would speak. But first, we would dance. Now tell me, what sort of fool wouldn't want to dance with a beauty like her?
Find another beauty, or I'll dance with you myself, just after I grab me a fence post.
Geralt, you saw it. I tried to resolve this peacefully, but they wish to fight.
Suits me just fine. Sounds like wonderful fun. Fence boards right over there for the taking.
Fear eat your stones.
That's the last plowing straw. No one accuses Vladimir von Evereck of cowardice.
Calm down, boys. Don't want to fight you.
Too damn bad, because we're going to tan your mutant freak hide.
That does it!
Show us what you got.
Hot damn, boy. You needn't ask me twice. Fence boards. The perfect weapon for sweaty-assed swineherds.
Perfect fit for your job, you plowing gentle fuck.
Never in my life have I reveled so fiercely. Step up. Who else wants a shave? Damned cretin creamed me. Embarrassing to take a licking from a boar. Had enough, peasant spawn? Thought yourself a match for a von Evereck? A witcher? Away with you. Begone. I've tired of looking at your slack jaw yaps. Where to, my love? I was to turn you into a lady.
Geralt, you must explain I was not at fault. They lunged at me. Well, go on, chase her.
In your dreams.
There it is. You fucked up. She's gone. Is that how you woo the ladies?
You always that charming in life?
It worked. More often than not.
Listen, tongue and fists on a leash from now on. Have your fun, but don't beat the wedding guests. With my hands.
Fine. I shall try.
Uh-oh. Shani approaches. Unlikely to be happy, eh?
You made this mess. You do the explaining.
Oh, all right.
Your methods... quite unusual. To woo a woman by beating up her brothers. Creative. Wonder what else you have up your sleeve.
My dear girl, what don't I have up my sleeve? I'd gladly demonstrate. Perhaps behind the barn?
I think you've demonstrated enough. Let's just enjoy ourselves, all right? You don't have all that much time left.
Your wish is my command, m'lady. I'd never deny a maid so fair-featured. Off we go. Let's do some dancing.
In my experience, witches and dancing don't exactly mix.
Today they mix like fire and oil, my love. We'll dance the barn down. Faster, faster, till we expire.
Special guests, the Witcher Geralt and his enchanting partner Shani. Musicians, something lovely for the loving couple.
At last, music for a loving embrace. Come, Shani, it's time you discovered my romantic side. A jig with you as its partner.
Oh, how humble you are.
I strive to be, yet should the need arise, I can't strut as proud as any peacock.
Perfect combination. Women must love you.
Well, not to brag, but...
Call it idle curiosity, but how many have you had?
Many. And not a scrub hag among them, I should add. Women with true class, oh, they're none to match your charms. Seems the music and the evening draw to a close. Know how a true dancer thinks his lovely partner.
Not sure I do. Say whatever you please, but you shall keep your hands to yourself. Understood?
Don't be upset, my peach. I couldn't resist.
I'm not upset. Just next time, don't lunge at me like that.
I'd had a long fast, so to speak. Hunger overwhelmed me. But yes, next time, I shall ask. Shani, may I kiss you?
You're incorrigible. Could I talk to Geralt for a moment?
What for? He'll have nothing of interest to say. The man's a drip.
Please.
Very well.
See how I've reeled her in? Now don't fuck this up.
Geralt, I'm curious what it's like when that ghost's inside you. Do you feel anything? have any control?
I feel everything. Don't have any control over what I do or say, though. Why do you ask?
Because I wonder what it would have been like to dance with you. Just you.
Well, I probably wouldn't have forced myself on you.
Forced myself? It was an innocent kiss, not more.
I don't know if I should thank you or if that should make me angry.
But don't get me wrong. I've thought about doing just that a few times, but...
But what?
But I'm not going to talk about it with him here. We can discuss it once he's gone.
I'll hold you to that.
Perhaps a bit of thanks is in order. Seems I've snared the little Robin for you.
You can shut up now.
What's going on now?
Nothing. Never mind. Happened to see the man who announced your song?
Yes. He acted as though he knew me. But we've never met. I was surprised. Who is he?
Gaunter O'Dim, Master Mirror. Wonder what he's doing here.
Then perhaps you should just ask him.
Yeah. He didn't show up without a reason. Need to talk to him.
Consider that he might have simply been nearby and dropped in on a whim.
Promise you this much, he never does anything simply, and certainly not on a whim.
I was to make merry, carouse. Yet here I've stood the last 5 minutes, listening to you talk. I'm going back in.
Better. Come, Shani. The night beckons us not to jabber it away.